Well, tomorrow, early voting begins for Minnesota's upcoming presidential primary. It will be held on March 5th, part of Super Tuesday, along with several other states. Kaya joins us now with what you need to know and what election officials are doing to prepare. Kaya?
Rena, Secretary of State Steve Simon says the biggest overall challenge this election season is likely to be the spread of disinformation. He says that's why his office held a briefing today to refresh everyone on voting basics and safeguards in place. So to vote early, Simon says Minnesotans can do so in person at a local election office, typically a city or county facility. Or you can go to mnvotes.gov and request an absentee ballot be mailed to you and you mail it back. Either way, you will have to choose whether you want a DFL party, Legal Marijuana Now party, or Republican Party ballot. You will only be choosing from presidential hopefuls. No other contest is included.
Voting from home is highly secure. When you order that absentee ballot to come to you in this election or any election in Minnesota, you have to provide some personal identifying information. It can be part of a social security number, it can be a driver's license number, and the voter signs, and a witness signs. Unless all three of those things are there, it will not be counted.
Officials also addressed artificial intelligence and deep fake content, adding to the threat of disinformation, telling us Minnesota is ahead of the curve because the legislature last year passed a law making it unlawful within 90 days of an election to disseminate a deep fake image without the consent of the depicted person if it was made with intent to influence an election. Rena?